thanks for my introduction. And first, I would like to thank organizers for giving me an opportunity to give a talk here. Okay. In the first section, this is the introduction of my talk. Today, I will explain generalization of Cartier transform. Cartier transform is a positive characteristic analog of Simpson correspondence introduced by Ogus and Vologodsky. So first, I will explain what Ogus Vologodsky did. Okay, let P, throughout my talk, P denotes a fixed prime number. And let S be a scheme defined over a field of characteristic P with the PD structure on zero ideal. This is my basis scheme in the introduction. And let X. The PD structure. let X be a smooth scheme over S, and let X prime be the Frobenius pullback over X, and we have a relative Frobenius then Ogus and Vologodsky compared two objects. The first one is OX module E with integrable connection, Nabla. This is map from E to E tensor OX, omega 1 X. This is omega 1 X over S, but I omit to write the base S. And to give an integrable connection is equivalent to give a D action, D0x over S action. This is the sheaf of PD differential operators. This is the sheaf of PD differential operators of level 0 introduced by Bechtero. Ogus Vologodsky compared this object and so-called Higgs module on X prime. This object was appeared in the Professor Leifu's talk. And this is OX prime module with additional structure, so-called Higgs field. In my talk, Higgs field means an action of the symmetric algebra of tangent bundle of X prime over S. So Higgs module is a module over a commutative ring. But the OX module with integrable connection is a module over a non-commutative ring. Ogus Vologodsky, to compare these two objects, Ogus Vologodsky used the Azumaya algebra structure of sheaf of differential operators over its center. Actually, D0 contains this symmetric algebra as its center. via the so-called P curve jamma. And furthermore, D0 forms an Azumaya algebra. Over center, so this symmetric algebra of rank P to the R, here at P to 2 times R. Here R denotes the relative dimension of X over S. More precisely, now we are working on the topological space X prime, so I should try to the push out by the relative Frobenius, but I omit to write the symbol of push out. This is not serious because relative Frobenius is homeomorphism. So we can identify X and X prime as a topological space. Okay, so D0 forms Azumaya algebra. So if we find a splitting module of D0 over a suitable scalar extension of this symmetric algebra, then we can compare such objects by using the so-called Morita equivalence. So a problem is how to find the splitting module of Azumaya algebra. I would like to give you one sufficient condition. To find the splitting module. Okay, in general, let X be a topological space, and let E be Azumaya algebra, sheaf of Azumaya algebra. Over a commutative ring R on X. Then assume we find a scalar extension of R. This is ring, and this is commutative ring, and Azumaya algebra of rank R to the square, and we find locally free S module of rank R with an action of E tensor R S on M. So we have a map of algebra from
S has nothing to do with the rest of the world.
R prime is
better.
Sorry for my abuse of notation. So it's okay.
R prime.
Okay. Is that okay? So here, I'm sorry for my bad notation. So if we are also given, if you also find an action of E tensor R prime on M, say alpha, then alpha must be isomorphism. Alpha is an isomorphism. So we can conclude that M is the splitting module of E tensor R prime. Okay. Actually, Ogus-Vologodsky constructed two splitting modules. I would like to write here.
So this is a general situation.
This is a general situation. We apply this sufficient condition in the case E is D0 and R is this symmetric algebra. First, they constructed the splitting module over the completion of. Now we use Zariski topology, but we will use Etal topology later. First, they constructed the splitting module of D0 over the completion of PD algebra defined by tangent bundle of X prime. Here, the completion is taken by the augmentation ideal. In this case, splitting module is K-dual. They denote K-dual. This is OX dual of K, but the definition is complicated, so I don't explain now. They construct a splitting module over this algebra and assumption of an existence of a lifting of X prime to S modulo P to the square. Okay, this is the first splitting module. And the second splitting module is a splitting module over the completion of symmetric algebra. In this case, splitting module is Frobenius pullback of the completion of symmetric algebra. To construct this module, we need assumption of a lifting of the relative Frobenius modulo P to the square. No, flat lifting. Lifting means, okay.
So what is the M in the first example?
K?
What is K?
Sorry, definition of K is complicated, so I don't explain now, so sorry.
And what did you write above the K? Check?
Or?
It's
K dual. K check? So I don't explain the definition of K, so I'm sorry.
So could you be more precise on the lifting here? So you lift what you lift?
Yes, yes. Yes, now I explain. Here. Modulo P to the square is this means morphism of schemes defined over P, Z over P to the square such that mod P reduction is nothing but X prime to S and so this is Cartesian. And we also assume X prime tilde and S tilde is flat over Z over P to the square. This is the definition of lifting.
In the second case, there is F. So it means you lift X, you lift X prime.
And S also S tilde?
S, yeah, S tilde, definitely.
Is it okay?
Okay.
So it follows that X prime roof to S roof is smooth.
Ah, yes, yes. Yes, automatically. okay. I would like to give some remarks. The latter assumption is obviously stronger than former assumption. As a consequence, the latter splitting module is smaller than the former splitting module in some sense. And a lifting of the relative Frobenius rarely exists globally on X. So the latter case is very local in some sense. So so in this sense, I call the latter splitting module local version. And the former splitting module global version. And I also remark that splitting module must be locally free. And local freeness of a splitting module comes from local freeness of the relative Frobenius. This is the point.
So the upper one is the basis of the lower
one. In some sense, yes. Actually, the former splitting module can be constructed by gluing argument. Yeah.
So this means that the completion, this is like a formal scheme kind of, okay. It's along the zero section, you mean?
Yes, completion by the augmentation ideal.
Yeah, so this is like considering the formal scheme of associated with the embedding of X prime. Okay.
Okay, this is Ogus-Vologodsky's theory. And next I would like to mention two generalizations. Of Ogus-Vologodsky's theory. First generalization is logarithmic version. Studied by Schepler. He generalized Ogus-Vologodsky's theory to the case of fine log schemes. And the second generalization is higher level version. This is studied by Michel and Lustum and Quiros. This means a generalization to the case of differential operators of higher level defined by Bechtel. Okay, now I can give you the aim of my talk. As you can easily guess from the title of my talk, today's aim is is log and higher level version. Of Ogus-Vologodsky's theory. Okay. So plan of my talk is the following. The first section is introduction, and the second section, my construction is also based on the Azumaya algebra structure of differential sheaf of differential operator. So first I would like to state Azumaya algebra property of our sheaf of differential indexed version of sheaf of differential operators of higher level. I will explain the definition of this guy. And the third section, this is final section of my talk. I would like to explain splitting module of this guy. This is plan of my talk. Okay. Okay, let's start next section. From now on, we are mainly working on the category of fine log schemes, and I denote a fine log scheme by a single letter, such as x. Okay, let x to s be log smooth morphism of fine log scheme defined over field of characteristic P. Let me introduce some notation. Let F be the n plus first relative robustness of X over S.
Do you use Cartier type or not?
No. And let pi denotes a natural projection from x prime to x. So we have the usual Frobenius diagram in log case. We have relative Frobenius and the projection. And the composition of these two guys are equal to
so what is the x prime? Is it just the pullback and the inverse and the final scheme?
No. Okay. Okay. We have x over s, and we take fiber product by the n plus first iteration of absolute Frobenius of x of s, and we denote it by x double prime.
But in which category?
In the category of fine log schemes. Later I will assume x to s is integral. But I don't assume of Cartier type. Then, natural map from x to x double prime is uniquely factored as x to x prime to x double prime. Here, the first map is required to be purely inseparable. And the second map is log et al. I denote the composition x prime to x double prime to x by, I denote this guy by pi. Is that okay? Okay, next let me introduce the divided power envelope. Let P.
So purely inseparable is in the sense of underlying scheme or also the log structure?
I think also log structure.
This means it's Kummer with only P.
Okay. Okay, let P be the divided power envelope. A log divided by envelope of level, I forgot to introduce m, level m of diagonal. Here m denotes a positive integer. And let i bar be the defining ideal of this exact cross immersion. Then, associated to I bar, we have filtration I bar, so called M periodic filtration. I bar to the something bracket N, M periodic filtration. Of I bar. And let the script P be the structure sheaf of this PDE envelope. And let P upper n be the quotient shift of P by I bar to the bracket n plus 1. Then this forms OX module via the first projection. And these guys form the projective system. And we take OX dual of Pn. This forms the inductive system. And we take inductive limit. And we put it dmx, but I simply denote it by d. this is Sachio-Ohkawa differential operators of level m. As usual, this is OX algebra. This is my terminology. Next, let me mention difficulties in the study of the logarithmic version of Ogus-Vologodsky's theory. First difficulty is the fact relative flatness is not finite flat. In general, this is serious because the local freeness of splitting module comes from local freeness of relative flatness. So we cannot simply generalize to the case of logarithmic scheme. And the second difficulty is our sheaf D. This is not Azumaya algebra. In general, actually, in logarithmic case, we can't describe its center by the symmetric algebra of tangent bundle. Okay, so these are, roughly speaking, these are difficulties in the study of logarithmic case. But we can overcome this difficulty by using index algebra associated to log structure introduced by Roaranton and Montagnon. First introduced by Roaranton. Let me recall the definition of indexed algebra. First, let script Y be the quotient sheaf of group envelope of log structure by the sheaf of invertible function on X. Okay, first I define A by quotient of MX group times OX over equivalence relation defined by AXY is equivalent to XAY for any A is in OX star. And X is in MX group. And Y is in OX. That A is not usual algebra. But that A has a structure of a kind of algebra called I-indexed OX algebra. I don't recall the definition of I-indexed OX algebra, but roughly speaking, this is OX algebra graded by sheaf I. Okay, and it is known that the Shirkov differential operator naturally acts on A, which preserves the index I. And this action satisfies a certain Leibniz type formula. So if we consider scalar extension of D to A, then this has natural structure of I index to A algebra, I index to A algebra, and I denote it by D tilde. This is appeared in the title of second section. We will study Azumaya algebra structure of this guy instead of usual D.
So A itself is viewed as indexed by the trivially indexed, or is it? So when you tensor two index things,
yes.
So you the index of the tensor should be something like the sum of the two.
Yes, this guy. This is, so we regard OX and D as a sheaf of a trivial sheaf. And this guy, this tensor is in the sense of indexed module. So, next, let me introduce another indexed algebra written by Bm plus 1 x over s, but I simply denote it by b. This is internal homomorphism of, we use dm plus 1 module f plus the d0 x prime. By the theory of Frobenius descent, dm plus 1 naturally acts on f upper star d0. And we also use dm plus 1 module structure on A. Okay, and I define map from B to A by G maps to G of 1 tensor 1. And takes a composition with map. So by the composition of these map, we regard B is a sheaf over I, and P has a multiplication and addition induced from that of A, and we also end up B with OX prime action via the right multiplication on this guy. Then we form the I index to OX prime algebra. Okay. Let me state one theorem proved by Laurentson and Montagnon. Is that okay?
It's better that you lower one because of the light. Of the camera. It's better to lower one.
Yes.
No, 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 no.
It's
red. 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 Yes. Okay, let me state theorem proved by Laurentson. In the case m is equal to 0, and also studied by Montagnon for arbitrary m. The assertion is the following. A is I indexed locally free B algebra, B module of rank P to the R times N plus 1. Here, R is OX rank of log cotangent bundle of X over S. So in some sense, this theorem overcome the first difficulty mentioned above. And I would like to first theorem one. This theorem overcomes the second difficulty. The assertion is there exists a map beta from symmetric algebra of tangent bundle of x prime to D. This is map of OX prime algebra, which is generalization of classical P curvature to the case of higher level called the P to the N plus 1 curvature. I don't explain the construction of beta such that D tilde, this is indexed version of D, forms Azumaya algebra over its center. And the center is isomorphic to scalar extension of symmetric algebra to B via inclusion from B to A tensor beta. This is first theorem. Sorry, I forgot to write the rank of Azumaya algebra. Azumaya algebra of rank P to the 2 times R times N plus 1. Okay. I have about 20 minutes. Okay. Next section, I will explain splitting module of this guy. Roughly speaking, main result is the following. We construct this splitting module of D tilde over corresponding to that table, B tensor, the completion of PD algebra, also B tensor, the completion of symmetric algebra under a certain liftability assumption. Modulo P to the square. So today I will explain about the latter case. So this is local version I mentioned in the first section. Let me first define one notion.
Here you assume some lifting.
Yes. I explain you more detail. Now I define a certain nice lifting of the relative Frobenius. This is my method is natural generalization of that of Gros and Le Stum-Quiros. First, let F tilde be a lifting of the relative provenance, modulo P to the square. So this means F tilde is mapped from X tilde to X prime tilde, and modulo P reduction of this map is coincide with F, and we also assume underlying scheme of X tilde and X prime tilde is flat over Z over P to the square. Then, F tilde is we say F tilde is a log strong lifting if for any M in this is section of log structure of X with a lifting with a lift M tilde in MX tilde, there exists M prime tilde. This is a section of X prime tilde, and this is a lift of pi upper star M. And there exists G tilde. This is a section of OX tilde, such that F tilde sends M prime tilde to M tilde to the P to the M plus 1 times 1 plus P times G tilde to the P to the M. This is our definition of log strong lifting.
Locally,
this is equation in Stoke. This is a definition of log strong lifting, and we can always take log strong lifting at least etal locally on X. Actually, if we have a lifting of the absolute provenance of X, then we can construct a log strong lifting in a natural way. Okay, let me state second theorem. We need additional assumptions. Let x to s be, we assume this is integral, and log smooth. And we also assume Ohm-Hynek type. Morphism of fine log schemes defined over a field of characteristic P. And we also assume S is Noetherian. And assume that we are given. Etal topology. Assume we are given a log strong lifting F tilde. Then the assertion is we have an isomorphism of indexed algebras from the tilde tensor. The statement is quite complicated. Scalar extension of D tilde to B tensor, the completion of symmetric algebra to matrix ring of B tensor, the completion of symmetric algebra. A tensor OX Frobenius fullback of the completion of symmetric algebra. So A tensor Frobenius fullback of the completion of symmetric algebra is a splitting module of D tilde over B tensor, the completion of symmetric algebra. This is second theory. Okay, I have about 10 minutes. Finally, I would like to explain the sketch of proof. First point is this splitting module, local freeness of this splitting module. This is locally free in the sense of indexed module over B tensor, the completion of symmetric algebra by Goranson and Montagnon. And of rank p to the r times n plus 1. So this module is locally free and also has the suitable rank. And the next point is action of this scalar extension on this module. I'm sorry. Is that okay? Okay, next point is to construct. Next point is to construct an action of, this is not indexed version, D tensor completion symmetry algebra on Frobenius pullback of this guy. If we construct such an action and by taking scalar extension to A, then we have a map appeared in the theorem. And by using Azumaya algebra property of D tilde and the fact rank of A tensor F upper star, the completion of symmetric algebra is suitable, we can conclude such a map is isomorphism by using the sufficient condition, index variant of sufficient condition stated in the first section. So, next point is this. Finally, I would like to explain how to construct such action. But today I have no time, so maybe I can give you how to construct an action of D on Frobenius pullback of this guy. I explain this action. The first step is to construct the morphism of divided power algebra from Frobenius pullback of divided power algebra defined by log cotangent bundle of x prime to P. P is the structure C of divided power envelope. This is morphism of PD algebra. And to construct this guy, we use strong lifting. And the second step is I will explain first step later to construct psi. And the second step is to construct log stratification. Of level M on Frobenius pullback of on this guy by using this psi, say rho n. Then associated to this stratification, we have D action on F upper star gamma dot TX prime. And by taking OX dual as D module, OX dual of F upper star gamma dot TX prime is nothing but Frobenius pullback of the completion of symmetric algebra. So we have this action. Okay, finally, let me explain step one. So next I will explain how to construct psi. First, let P tilde be the log divided power envelope of diagonal of X tilde. Then we consider the following diagram. We have this PD envelope and we have diagonal, and we composed with take a composition by F tilde times F tilde. This is mapped from X tilde times X tilde to X prime tilde times X times X prime tilde. And we also have log strong lifting F tilde, and there is diagonal of X prime tilde. Okay, and by using our finite rates assumption of finite type and Noetherian, we can check that the latter horizontal map factored as log infinitesimal neighborhood. This is log infinitesimal neighborhood. So I need more space. This is a log infinitesimal neighborhood of order n for some large number n. I denote it by psi tilde sub n. And let J be the defining ideal of OP tilde to OX tilde. Then by local calculation, the image of J and psi tilde sub n is contained in ideal generated by P. So this is psi tilde upper star n. And multiplication by P exclamation induces isomorphism between P OP tilde to OP tilde over P OP tilde to P OP tilde, because we are working on the modulo P to the square, and OP tilde is flat over Z over P to the square by our assumption. And then this guy is mod P reduction of the structure sheaf of divided per envelope. So this is nothing but OP. Okay, this is a map of OX prime module. And because this map factored through the ideal generated by P, this is factored through omega 1 x prime tilde, and also factored its mod P reduction. And the image of this guy is contained in the underlying PD structure of OP. So this map naturally extends to divided power algebra. And by taking linearization.
So P was just the not your block without, so it means before lifting. Could you remind us what was P?
What was P? P is log divided by envelope of diagonal of X. Is that okay? Yeah. Okay, and this map, the image of this map is contained in the underlying PD structure of OP. So by universal mapping property of divided power algebra, we have a map from gamma dot omega 1 x, x prime here, omega 1 x prime, to this guy. And by taking linearization, we have this map psi. Okay, I stopped here.
Any question or comments?
But what is the psi related to P curvature in sense?
Yes.
Could you maybe explain the case m equal 0?
Yes, so
you can see the P curvature.
In some sense, this map is lift of P curvature.
And the integrality condition on your map is to ensure flatness or something?
Yes, yes. Actually, by integral assumption, OP tilde is flat over, this is log smooth integral, so this is flat over OX tilde, and by our assumption of lifting, OX tilde is flat over Z over P to the square.
Thank you.